future that year by year recedes before us and leaves us then. But that's no matter. Tomorrow we'll run faster, stretch out our arms farther, and one fine morning. So we get on, boats against the current, borne back ceaselessly into the past. All right, so now that we're done with Gatsby, we're going to start our research project, just because you guys didn't have enough work to start with. All right. So as you guys know, probably from last year's class, you're not going to be doing the typical research paper. You're not going to be doing the Honors Junior research paper.
Oh, yeah!
Don't get too excited now. We're still going to be doing something to replace it. We're going to be doing the Honors Junior English research project instead.
Here, let me pass out this packet to you guys. And just take a look.
See what you're in store.
Okay, what are we even writing about?
Okay, good question. What our topic is this year are positives going on in public education K-12 in America. Now, don't be discouraged by the topic. I know it seems like it's really just a topic that, how are you going to write about that? But there are so many things that you can write about. For example, you could write about music education. Is that a positive? I think it is. I don't know what your opinions are, but you can find something that, what is something that has affected you in school? What are programs that have affected you and been a benefit to you? You can write about that. Do you guys have any questions on what would be acceptable, an acceptable topic?
Like sports education,
or music education, art education, special education.
Programs. Yeah, special education.
Dual enrollment.
Yeah, I mean, these are all great things to write about. Okay, so as you guys can see, I passed out to you guys some abstracts from last year. You can see the format is going to be totally different from what you're used to. All of this is in size 12 Times New Roman font. And as you can see, it's very nice, very professional. The top, you're going to have the word abstract as your kind of like your title in the center. And then you're not going to indent your abstract. You do not need to indent an abstract. And then you're going to kind of explain just a brief summary of what was your article about. And then at the bottom, you're going to highlight in key terms, you're going to italicize, put three key terms. What are key terms, you're probably thinking, right? Okay. So key terms are basically terms that are used in the article. They don't have to be used in your abstract. They can just be words that were used in the article that mean something specific to that article. For example, somebody last year wrote an article about a school that separates classes from promotes and demotes. and the word promotes and demotes means something different to the students at that school. Also, the word promotes and demotes has a special connotation. So what you want to do is then later on your third page, you're going to want to write about your three key terms, and you're going to want to explain why the author used the words that they did, what connotations they have, what emotions they're going to evoke in people, and what they mean in the story and what they mean normally outside of the story or the article. And you're also going to want to do something that's very important. Whenever you're reading an article, you need to evaluate the author's bias and evaluate the author's technique and writing style. What did the author do that was effective? Was it a persuasive essay? Was it an informative essay? What was his purpose in writing it, his or her purpose? What tools did they use to accomplish their purpose? And are they biased? For example, if they're writing about a school that's doing amazing things, and they're the principal of that school, they're going to be biased. Do you understand what I'm saying by that? Mm-hmm. Okay, so the other aspect of the abstracts are your sources. Okay, so as do you guys have your packets here with you guys?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're going to want to take a look at these sources. And as you can see, it says the resource categories. You can use one scholarly journal, one newspaper or magazine article, one piece written, presented for the purpose of public advocacy, which is an education bill, a board proposition, educational proposal, board meeting. It could also be a board ruling. For example, a student last year used a court case, and people have actually used laws as well. So that would be that. And then there's one non-contemporary source, which is just a 17th century, 18th century, 19th century piece. It's going to be a scholarly journal basically from that era. But it has to, if you're doing this, it has to relate to something that's going on right now. It has to relate to education as of right now. So you're going to be doing a total of 8 abstracts, but you have to have one of each. So one of them you're going to use twice, or you're going to use as many as you need. But you have to use at least all 5 of these different categories. Okay, so how are you going to find all these things? How are you going to find a scholarly journal? How are you going to find a newspaper article? You're going to have an hour once a week in class to get this done. And these are going to be due every other week. So you're going to have plenty of time to get this done if you use the time in class that is provided for you.
And can we use like other sources like newspapers?
Yes, you have to use one source that's a newspaper. The newspaper article can be something that's online. If you're on, for example, the newyorktimes.com, something like that, you can use an article from there because that still is a newspaper. For the one non-text source, that's going to be like a web page, a radio broadcast, all that.
All of these different sources that you're using are going to help you out later on when you're writing your project, because you can use all these different types of sources to get your multiple sources points.
They're going to be 50 points, and you have to pass that category in order to pass the final project. Okay, so after we finish the abstract part of your project, what you're going to do is every week you're going to upload the abstracts onto the resource list, which is on my website. You're just going to click on it and you're just going to see, does anybody else have my article? And if somebody already has yours, you can't use it. So you need to do that, check that before you actually write your article. But you need to upload it then, and then upload it to turnitin.com and turn it in to me. Also, after that part, we're going to start on your actual research paper part of your project. So this is going to be worth 500 points. Website itself, you're going to get 200 points
For job points, you're going to need to get 200 points, and you can get these points by doing publicity for the website, for helping out with the website, maybe technology, making videos, maybe taking pictures. All of these things, just helping out with the project, is going to give you your 200 job points. So as a total, this project is going to be worth 700 points, plus the 30 points for each abstract. This is going to be a huge amount of points. You can also go to 600 out of 500, so you can get 100 points of extra credit on this project. That's a lot of extra credit. And you're going to turn in these articles to your copy editors, who are going to look these over at least 3 times before you turn it in to me. And basically what this is going to do is going to allow you to create the best papers possible. And then I'm going to say, you know what, this is a great paper, I think it should be published. Or you're going to submit it to our assistant editors, who are going to say, I think this is a great paper, this should be published. Once you're published, you get your 25 published points. You need to get those. If you do not get those, you cannot earn extra credit, and you also lose 25 points for not getting them, because you need to be published. That's a requirement. There are some things that are requirements, and if you don't get them, you cannot get extra credit, and you also lose points. Yes, Olivia.
So where will this be published?
This will be published on a website called thethunderproject.org. It's already a website. You guys can check it out.
I'm not angry anymore.
I mean, it's going to be a lot of work. I'm not going to lie to you, it's going to be a lot of work. Do not procrastinate. But the thing is that the average for my class was over 500 points. So that means that the average...